Good morning, Thursday, February 4th. It is a beautiful yet cold 54 degrees Fahrenheit here in Florida, Central Florida, Valrico, Florida, I guess more like West Central Florida. And today I'm working on a replacement windshield frame for Cole's 1973 Triumph TR6. And this one is in really good shape, just needs to be cleaned up a little bit. I need to scrape off some of the factory glue. The one that was in Cole's car had really bad rust down here at the bottom of the frame where the water collects. And this one is in much better shape. I was able to pick this one for $100. And it's, like I said, in very, very good shape. I'm going to clean it up real good, sand it down, do a few coats of primer, and then I will be doing some satin black paint. The original had a satin finish to it, so that's something that we'll be doing. Let's see if I can turn the frame over so you can see the backside. Backside still has the original vinyl here. As you can see, some of it's coming apart, but that's okay because I have a replacement for this, so I will be replacing that and have a new one from, I believe, the Roadster factory. So this should be an interesting, hopefully fun project to try to get this cleaned up. It does have a couple of little small spots that are starting to rust, but nothing like the old one. And here on the bottom, we're in pretty good shape here on the bottom. So in the next video, you should see this sanded, ready for primer. So here we go. Okay, so here we are. I was able to get all of the old finisher plastic that went on the inside of the frame and managed to scrape off all of the glue that was in there. That was used to hold it into the interior frame. However, we did come into a problem here. As you can see, we've run into a hole. Pretty common in these window frames for the, or windshield frame for the TR6. So we will see this evening if me and my buddy Ken Dave can do something to tack that up and clean that up a little bit so there will not be a gaping hole there. Again, it's on the inside, but still, we'd like to make it nice and smooth and clean. So next step now will be to take the primer and go ahead and start priming. Okay, I was able to get a couple of coats of primer here on the windshield frame for Cole's 76 Triumph TR6. And it's looking pretty good, better than it was. You can see here we've got a nice coverage of primer, and as I said before, we are going to go over to my friend Dave's house this evening to do some work on that one spot. I was able to grind it out and get all the rust out, and I primed it so that at least we could stop any additional rust from happening. But that is the frame for the 73 TR6, and we will see what we're able to do this evening with the hole. Here we are in the garage with our good friend Dave, and we are applying some, what are we applying, Dave? We're applying Evercoat polyester glazing to the hole we had in the 73 TR6 frame. And Dave, who's a master at everything, is doing this for me. So we're getting this filled in, and we are going to see if we can resurrect this frame that's new to us. It's definitely in better shape than the one that we had. So we're gonna see if we can fill that hole in right there. So I'll come back to you in a few minutes. Good morning, everyone. It is Friday, February 5th. Happy Friday to everybody out there. I had wanted to try to shoot this video last night, but ran out of time and had to get another coat of primer on the area that we repaired. So as a follow-up to the last video, we did do some repair here on the end. We were able to close the hole up, and we are now in good shape as far as trying to start spraying a few coats of the satin black onto the frame. As usual, I'm a little short on paint because the local home improvement store only had one can of the Krylon left, so I'm going to have to go back again today, but I have enough to at least get a coat on the inside of the windshield frame. But really happy with the way this came out. Again, it's, in my opinion, best to try to reuse what we've got and not throw anything away. So we keep everything, and we were able to use actually some parts from the original window frame that we needed for this one. So also just a little audio note here. I noticed that some of the, when reviewing my videos, the videos, some of the volumes are a little soft. So I'm gonna try to start using my headphones, which are noise canceling headphones, so we can get a little bit better audio. So if you notice a big drop in the sound, I apologize. And it's just a little bit of a learning curve for me. But we are ready to start the process of doing some painting. Another glorious day here on the west coast of Florida. Not a cloud in the sky. Definitely warmer today than it was. And I'll shoot some more video later today. Thanks for watching. Okay, I was able to go to Lowe's and pick up some more of my favorite paint, Krylon Fusion All-in-One, satin black, by the way. And as you can see, I've got a couple of coats here on the inside of the windshield frame for the 73 TR6. And as you can see, it's drying right now, but it's looking very nice. The key will be doing the other side, which is the side that you will see from the road and from everything, going into the garage on my 73 TR6. You can see here, there's only a small area that you actually can see. By the time you have the windshield gasket on, there's really not much of the frame that you can see, with the exception of here on the sides, going down, and a little bit at the top, because this is covered by this sill plate that goes over, I guess you could call it a finisher, for the top of the windshield. So in this particular one of my car, I have a brand new windshield. I do have two original windshields that are not quite perfect, but they are original. And through some good luck, ended up with an extra brand new windshield from the glass guy. So Cole will have three different windshields to choose from. So, all right, I will flip this over and see if we can work on the other side. Here we are, friends, the final video of this restoration of the windshield frame for the 73 Triumph TR6. I'm very pleased and happy with the way it came out. Several coats of primer, lots of sanding, so that only you can see just an inch or so of the frame. But hey, it is a lot better than what we started with. And the hole that we had, the small hole we had, has been filled. And so I'm very happy with the final product. It's going to be a very nice frame to go into Cole's 73 TR6. So I think that we did a good job here, and happy with the outcome. Again, the Krylon satin black finish has a nice sheen to it, and I think that we will be very pleased with it once the windshield and the gasket's in. So another job completed on the road to restoring the 73 TR6. We appreciate everybody's comments out there, and thanks for watching.